Ladies and gentlemen, can I please have your attention? Stop what you're doing and listen.
DOD45.
It's raw. It's fucking raw.
How much do you charge for this dish?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
That's what your interest are.
Do you like it? Who you gonna be talking to?
First things first, the first.
Love, hey.
Talk, questions, conversations, laughter.
Hello, Adrian.
Yo, Adrian. We did it.
Hello, Earthlings.
People of Earth, how are you?
I'm Ty of ArtByTai, here with my co-host Adrian, and you're watching The Dish, our DOD45 bonus content from last week's episode with the Dead Can Rap. That's Remi Rough and Mike Ladd. Those guys, oh boy, they were a real joy to hang with.
Yep.
Hey, that Remi Rough is a legit as balls graffiti artist.
I know.
Yeah.
He put his name up recently.
Yeah.
On the wall.
That dude has some kick-ass pieces out there in the concrete jungles of the world. It's just legitimate fucking really bomb-ass shit. Since like 1984. Yeah. Anyway.
I know. He's a great artist.
We didn't get into it in their episode, but that iconoclast movement that Remi Rough was involved in, that's pretty amazing stuff. He's working on a book about it that he's recently posted about, which should be out in 2025. So keep your eye out for that. Really looking forward to the album that he's working on with Buddy Peace.
Mm-hmm.
That's near complete, I think.
Oh, cool.
And hey, happy Friday, you freaky humans. It's Friday. Yeah. This is our first Friday night premiere of the Dish episode. And I'm curious to see how it works. I'm certain there are less people in the live chat because it's a Friday night. But the Dish episode...
I may not be here.
Huh?
I may not be here.
Yeah. Well, the Dish episodes can be enjoyed at any time. So, quick few things before we start getting dished by Remi Rough and Mike Ladd. In this new bonus material, we ask our guests to reveal answers to some of their first, worst, and thirsts. Everybody, I'd like you to join in the live chats if you can, ever. You know, try to do those in any future episodes. It's a lot of fun. I'm loving the theme music that you're hearing right now. That's from our man, Buddy Peace. He produced Dish theme music for us, and we're forever grateful for that. We're also grateful to our affiliates like Strange Famous Underground Sound Magazine, Ground Haven Speaker Face, and many more. Speaking of affiliations, real quick, we're now reaching out to sponsor affiliates just to promote the show through social media posts, YouTube advertising, etc. That stuff we can get done for pretty cheap coin. So we're offering spots, shout outs, stuff like that. If you want to figure out how you can get your be a part of the show for pretty for minimal money, we could reach out to me at ty@artbytai.com or ty@dod45.com. We're going to be doing the show regardless if we get sponsors or not, but for minimal money we could possibly triple our audience. And that would be good. That's good for independent music. So if you have a product, art, album, or anything out there that you think would align with our show and want to get involved, you can email me. I can provide you with the price sheet of what that's going to be. This is all new stuff for us, so yeah, just reach out to me. You'll be surprised how low of a rate we're going to probably be asking for. We'll have weekly, monthly, or annual rates. So yeah, check in with me if you're interested. What's that?
Oh, I was going to say maybe you should start a Patreon.
Oh, that's potential.
If it's similar.
It's kind of similar. Yeah. I mean, lots of podcasts do a Patreon thing. Maybe I might do that and just, yeah. Because
you can do it early release at least too.
Yeah, that's maybe. True. Well, and it's not like it's not like this is a money grab or anything. It's like just to, it'll all be used just to get promotions for the show to get it out to more people. We have great audience already, but I'd like to, if we can get this in the ears and eyes of more people, that's just a bonus for the artists. The independent artists, independent producers and stuff who are on our show. So if you want to just get a name mention, shout out, dedication, anything like that, any kind of announcement, all of that. For the cost of...
a coffee.
A taco.
You can save a child's life.
For the cost of a taco from Terror Tacos in St. Louis, Missouri,
you
could
out.
Get in on the
Terror?
Show. I am. I want to shout out Terra Tacos. Terra Tacos. That's an affiliate of ours.
Congratulations on winning the best tacos in St. Louis.
Yep. Best tacos in St. Louis for Terra Tacos. We're friends with the owner and...
And your work is in the...
And my artwork is in there. It's a great spot. So if you're ever in St. Louis, go hit up Terra Tacos. They and if, but if you can't stand heat...
Then
get out of the kitchen.
No, don't get the Diablo or whatever it was called.
When they say that it's hot at that rest, like if you go to Terra Tacos and you're reading something that says it's hot, believe them. It's hot. Well, it's spicy.
I got the Margot Robbie, which is Margot Robbie. Like one of the spiciest, and I could still use
Adrian's
the
different breed. Hey, real
but
quick.
It was delicious.
I made an observation about Halloween, and it actually came up. Or it's going to come up in our discussion with Mopes. That's an episode ahead. When we were younger, you and I, our generation, we were trying to become older faster. Like when we were young, we were like, I can't wait to get old. But this generation, I think, is trying to stay younger longer. And I think we were there when I was talking about this. But my niece who's in college, she drove home from college to go trick-or-treating with her siblings.
I didn't know that.
Yeah. Our kids had... friends in from out of town. One of them, they're 18, 19, and 17
year
they old. Had friends in from out of town and they all went trick-or-treating. When we were 14, that was done trick-or-treating.
Well, we got rejected.
Well, I
and
know, but
all these kids lost a COVID year.
Well, that yeah, so well, I'm just saying, could it be that our generation with kids, our generation, you and I, those of us who have kids, we tried to grow up too quick, and now we regret it. So we embrace and enable our kids wanting to stay younger, longer for our children. Or is it just that this generation's figured out that being old is a joke?
I don't have an answer. I don't feel like I was trying to get older.
Oh, really?
I was only trying to get old enough.
Maybe we were forced into being older at our age.
Lots of kids.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know. It just seems like generationally,
there's still plenty of kids that are not like ours and that are
that's true.
Carriers are it's hard to say because they're homeschooled.
All right, well, we're gonna
they're
get
weirdo
in
homeschool yeah kids.
they are weirdo homeschool kids, but they're not so we're gonna get into the dish episode. There was one thing I want to talk about in the episode with them, their episode that you just watched earlier this week. I was wearing my Samoa shirt, and we're talking about Samoa. I just wanted to bring up this other quick thing about Samoa. I wasn't born in Samoa, so that leads it. That's just a preface. Anyway, that's just that. This is that will help for this thing I'm going to mention. When I was growing up, I was trying to learn how to speak Samoan. So I'd always ask my dad to teach me how to, I'd try to learn certain, And I asked my dad how to say the word sorry, what the word for sorry in Samoan was. And he was very matter of fact, said, there's not a word. There's no word for sorry. And back then when I heard that, I was like, what the hell? What, like, why not? Okay. Why, what if you were sorry about something? And I think you were there for the conversation, right? I just recently realized there's not a word for sorry because island life, you don't do things to people that would cause an apology. You just be good. You just don't. I think that I'm realizing that that's why there wasn't a word for it.
Yeah.
You would never do. You just, I don't know. My lifelong mantra has been don't be a dick. And island life is uncomplicated like that. There are dynamics and issues and weird things, that happen in the islands. But in Samoa, there is that life of, like, you just living your life and you just be, I guess you get my point, right?
Yeah. So you be good to others and help them when you need to. The Fa'a Samoa.
Yeah, the Fa'a Samoa. That's a real thing. Yeah, Fa'a Samoa's.
It's basically just a regular moral compass, I think, for people who just are good.
Everyone's
They don't need the guidance of a Bible type thing.
Yeah.
They're not. You just be good and do the right thing. For the sole sake of that's what you should be doing.
And also, here's another little thing on that. a community, because they're out there on a, you're out there on a small little island alone, you know. It only benefits the, what's good for the goose is good for the gander. Mm-hmm. Like, you just got to be good to each other. It's a small little island. Yeah. And that's generations and generations and generations of living. And not much has changed. I mean, Western world is kind of, and
it's
Asian world.
Have, and TikTok.
Yeah. And things like that have happened, but it's still the same. So anyway, I don't know. That was just an observation I had when we were having a conversation. I think when we were talking to Cass One about it or something.
Something. I think yeah. it was, we were at the show, so I don't think so.
Oh, okay. But yeah, it just kind of like came. I just was like, just realized it. Okay.
I guess.
Our Christmas episode, we're going to be recording that in Tucson.
Oh.
And also, oh shit, I had, that. Yeah, I guess I don't know, that was it. All right, let's set the table.
Wait, I just wanted to say something.
Oh yeah, oh, I'm sorry.
Or maybe I'll say it after. Go ahead, say it after.
Let's set the table. Earlier this week, our guest was The Dead Can Rap. And if you haven't watched the episode from Wednesday, press pause here. Go back and watch that first. Things will come up in here that were mentioned there and vice versa. So anyway. All right, here we go. Friday it is. Here we are. I'm ready to be served. I'm hungry. This is The Dish with The Dead Can Rap.
First things first, but the first was best.
Questions, conversations, laughter.
All right, here we are now. Table set. Thank you for joining us on The Dish, our bonus discussion of your guys' appearance on the DOD45 show. We're going to find out how well you guys know each other. I'll ask a question, and you'll each have to guess how your friend will answer. Let's hash this out. Time for you to dish out your first, worst, and thirst. All right, here's the first question. This first question is for Remy, and it's about Mike, and then so Remy will give us his answer, but then Mike, you'll give us the real answer. What's the first liquid that Mike drinks in a day?
I'm gonna guess water.
Survey says coffee.
You know, when you said that, I thought you said cervezas.
It's the title.
Okay, there we go, Mike. This one's about Remy. What was Remy's first paying job?
Oh, God damn.
You do know this.
Fucking pub liquor?
Because you loved him as well.
I don't know. Muppet repairman? I have no idea.
For Jim Henson?
Yeah. I mean, you know, he's plugged in.
Charles Manson. Puppet repairman for Charles Manson. That would be a great job. I'm not sure it has much longevity.
Yeah.
I just worked for my dad. My dad had like a transport company. I would pack really expensive paintings that were like Bruegels, Canalettos, like crazy expensive paintings. And I would sit in a warehouse packing them. That was my favorite job.
Nice. Oh, yeah, good. Oh, shit. Sorry, my phone's blowing up here.
It's Mr. Dibbs. He's like, I'm back.
Who was the first celebrity that Mike ever met?
Oh, I'll give you a hint. It's in a record. It's in a song that you know.
Not Lenny Kravitz. No, that was way later. I have to literally plow through. I can't remember.
All the albums.
I can't remember. I know, like, literally all his songs, most of the lyrics. I know the lyrics better than he knows them, and I can't remember them now.
It was Nelson Mandela's with my mom.
Of course.
This thing called the South African Education Project. Yeah. She would get, this was during apartheid, where she would bring South African kids to the U.S. for higher education over here, over there. And it was a dangerous job. Like, their offices got raided. She saw a person get abducted, just pulled off the street. You know, it was, people don't understand how bad it was. Like, her passport, my mom's black, and her passport said honorary white on it.
Oh, man.
It was like a really, really hectic time. Yeah. But, you know, she was heavily involved in the anti-apartheid movement.
That's like the coolest. That's the coolest answer we've had to that question.
Yeah. I know. It's like, I'll see you guys later. Yeah.
You got to meet him at an airport once.
Yeah, fantastic. Yeah. Who was Remy's first celebrity crush?
Oh, God, it would be something way cooler than I'm thinking of. I got what's her name? Hurley in my head.
Elizabeth Hurley?
Yeah, but that's way, Remy's older than
I know, way before that.
I would think like Raquel Welch. What, maybe it's me. I'm projecting.
Yeah, you're projecting. Kate Bush.
Kate Bush?
Yeah.
Kate Bush.
That's a cool crush.
My mum had like a Kate Bush record, and I just used to go, she's a babe.
That's a much cooler crush than anything I was gonna have.
Yeah, I love Kate Bush.
What was the first movie that really scared Mike?
Goonies.
Oh, not far. American Werewolf in London. We all went to somebody's birthday, and they like, and it was the 70s or 80s, whatever, you know, people like, oh, let's bring the kids to Harvard.
79, I think it was. It's so confusing, though, because one minute you're terrified, next minute you're laughing, and then you're terrified, and then you're laughing. Comedy.
But I had the best dream. After I saw that movie, I mean, we must have been 12, and I had the best dream that I remember to this day, where like me and my friends are chasing this werewolf, then the werewolf's chasing us. And then there's one point where we've been in the city, and then we run up in the country, and then there's this one cop, and we think we're saved, and we're like, come up to the cop, and he's like this hayseed, you know, like really like 6'5" guy, blonde hair, and he's, you know, just sort of doing that thing with his cap, like, I don't know, guys, what's going on? And we're like, you know, Mr. Cop, you gotta save us from this werewolf. And he's like, okay, I'll see what I can do. And right then the werewolf just goes like, like bounding up the road. It's like this country road, and the cop pulls out his gun in slow motion, and the riff just rips his fucking mouth right off, and the cop's just like, oh, and we're like, oh no. And I woke up in my bathroom.
Oh my god,
in
your bathroom.
I mean,
when I was small, I'd go to the bathroom when I got really scared because it was the brightest room in the house.
Oh. You know,
because it's
amazing that cop was unarmed.
All right, that is the dad joke of the week.
It's a good one. Can I ask real quick, how was that movie perceived in London?
Oh man, it's huge. Just a brilliant film. Jenny Agutter, who is the woman in that, who has, you know, this shower scene, which when you're a young man, you're like, oh my God, hello.
Yeah.
is now in a program called Call the Midwife as a very elderly nun. And I watched this program and I can't unsee the young her in the shower of the film.
What's that doing to your opinion of nuns?
Well, maybe. I mean, I went to like an Italian youth club when I was called Scalabrini when I was young, and the nuns there were vile. They used to hit you and stuff. So yeah. I don't have a good opinion of nuns. But Jenny Agutter, on the other hand, she's a goddess.
What was the first movie that Remy cried from, or that made Remy cry?
It's easy.
Neverending Story?
Oh.
Star Wars.
Star Wars?
What part?
Dude, every Star Wars film that comes out, I take my family and they sit there. And as the yellow writing starts coming up like that, my daughter and my wife both look at me like this.
And you're crying.
And they literally wait for me to start crying. I cry. Those films are so magical to me.
Yeah.
That I literally, and I can't, and they're like, what do you think of the film? And I can't speak because I'm so choked up. I cry at everything. I just cry at any film, any emotion. Like, I cried at The Mandalorian. Like, when Luke was walking through, you know, young Luke, I was in tears. I was crying. But I went to see Deadpool, and not every single, not to do spoilers, but every single cameo, I was like, and my daughter, my 20-year-old daughter, was sitting next to me.
Wait a minute! I thought you were crying.
Like, I actually went to see. Oh my God! I went to see Guardians of the Galaxy 3, And I went on my own because my daughter was in university in Bristol, but we'd agreed we'd go on the same day in different cities.
Oh, cute.
So I went, and I've got like a man sitting to my left and I've got like a 12-year-old kid to my right. And like at one point, the guy on my left turned around to me and said, "You're right, mate." I'm like, "Yeah." And then the kid went, "You okay, mister?" And I was like, "I'm fine." I mean, I was a wreck. I came out of that film a wreck. Yeah, I mean, you know, Marvel's fallen off a cliff since then. But I mean, you know, that wow. film, I was in bits. I came out, I had streaks down my cheek.
What was the first thing Mike bought on credit?
I'm going to guess it was something to do with making music, like a sampler.
I wish. It was a sandwich. I was in college. You know, they pushed credit cards me.
That's so American, man.
It is so American.
How long did it take you to pay off that sandwich?
He's still paying it off.
Yeah.
Hurt the hell out of that thing so fast.
What was Remy's very first writing moniker?
Oh, your very first tag?
Yeah.
I don't know if even I can remember that. I think.
Mikey. No.
just say something rude. I think it was theme because I was the theme, but I can't remember. It's so long ago.
Did you have a strange spelling of it too, or was it?
No, when I was like first started being okay at graph, I used to write rough RUF, and then. Like that became R-O-U-G-H because I wanted to do bigger pieces. I wanted my piece to be extended. And then I added an E. So it's Ruffy. and everyone was like, "Is it Ruffy?" I was like, "No, it's rough. But it's got an E at the end." I'm like, "And so what? Were you the fucking language police?" And then like a friend of mine, a friend of ours, Charlie Dark, two friends of ours, actually, Stormy Mills, amazing artist from Australia, and Charlie Dark, both used to call me Remi Rough. So Remi Rough just stuck. But yeah, I had so many names. The thing when you start graffiti, it's like trying to find a needle in a haystack. It's just like, it's like ADHD overload. But I hated being a graffiti writer when I first started. I just wanted to be amazing at it.
Right. Yeah, I had the worst names. I was only good in the book. Anytime I tried to take the book to the street, it never worked out the same. What was Mike's first proper studio album?
Language? Was that it?
No. It's Armageddon.
Easy Listening for Armageddon.
That was the first proper studio album?
Sorry, in my head it was Language of Armageddon. Easy Listening for Armageddon, yeah.
I thought you were thinking, in what language was it?
That was a VJ. Was that with VJ?
Yeah. In what language?
Mike's made so many records. It's insane.
There's a lot. It's great. And they're all great.
He could do an Instagram account just for his albums. It would look so cool as just the grid.
Yeah, but that takes us back to the whole social media thing. What was the name of Remy's first girlfriend?
Trisha.
Oh, you knew it?
No.
What? Oh.
No idea. I think it was probably a girl called Debbie Bragg, who weirdly I'm in touch with. She's a photographer, and I bump into her at art things sometimes. And like when I was 10 years old, like, you know, so it wasn't like we weren't boyfriend and girlfriend, but you know, we used to tell people that we were boyfriend and girlfriend.
Well, she's got a cool name.
Debbie Brown.
Yeah, it's a cool sounding name. All right, we'll go into the worst, and then
has anyone gotten these dishes right?
We usually only have one guest, so just the one guest who does them. But when we have multiple guests, it gives us a chance to.
This is hard. I want to like redo this thing.
You're such a perfectionist.
It's like trying to finish your album. Just focus on your album.
Focus on the album.
No, man, we got to go back. Let me review.
What will Mike say is the worst Halloween candy?
Oh, like the fizzy peach shit things.
They have that?
Yeah.
Okay, that's the worst. No, I was going to say candy corns, but anything fizzy peach, that's pretty bad.
Yeah. Yeah. Like, you, we both, we're not fans of that kind of sweet.
Guys probably don't have candy corn.
Yeah, do you have candy corn, Remy?
No, you don't. You know, they brought Halloween here. We kind of, we light
to it. See, you saw that, you two saw that response, right? He just went blank.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, they, I don't know. You sent us
Halloween. Yeah. We're polite to it. You know, we tolerate it.
We got it from you.
Yeah, we got
it. You lot go nuts over it. We're like, yeah, okay, right.
We Americanized it.
Halloween.
I love it when Americans come here though, and they say, "Hey, do you guys like? Do you celebrate the 4th of July?" And I'm like, no.
Yeah.
Why not? Right. What? Really? You're asking me that question?
You should be celebrating that you got rid of us.
Yeah.
What will Remy say is the worst insect?
Oh, he knows that one.
Spiders.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. That's great.
I'm not scared of them, but they are. Like, I picked up Teddy's bowl. I picked up the dog bowl the other day, and there was a fucking spider like that under it. And I was like, wah! and I spilt water everywhere, obviously. And then I had to get like a glass, put the glass down, get a bit of paper, and take the, because I can't kill spiders.
You got to take them out.
But yeah, they're the worst.
Well, that's pretty apropos. The episode started with, in our intro, I just told the story that yesterday morning I walked out of the house and right into a full fucking web. Right into my face.
It's like Spider-Man live upstairs or something.
I hate spiders.
It was outside.
It was outside.
Get up, Indiana Jones.
What does Mike think is the worst sound?
Me rapping.
No, Remy.
And it's the look he gives me. It's kind of like this.
Remy. That is so not true.
I don't know. Like, there's two annoying sounds in Paris that annoy the shit out of me. One is this, when you're on the metro, it goes, doo-lee-lee. Hate that. Hate it. I hate it so much. I literally, something snaps inside me and I want to kill someone.
What's the sound?
You know, the doo-lee-lee. The little kind of jingle.
For the ba-da-da.
I hate it. I hate it so much. And then the other one is they have the police sirens. The frequency is so unnecessarily high.
Yeah.
It's like, just tank. It's like, how can you be scared of cops that are like, pum, pum, pum.
I know, it's stupid. So maybe it's those.
Exactly.
No, neither of those. I forget what it was though. Survey says. Scurvy says, arr. I'm a pirate with my Dawson.
You love pirates.
Yeah, I do.
He does. He's a big pirate fan.
Yeah, remember what I said for the worst sound? Oh, yeah, I know. You were close. I said French children's songs.
Yeah.
I'm still traumatized by that shit.
Yeah, I don't even know what they are.
Le coco, le crocodile. You have to live through it.
But, yeah.
I apologize for Europe. I apologize.
What city did Remy have his worst experience ever in?
Worst experience ever?
Yeah.
Bristol.
No.
Let me see about, I don't know, it'd have to be someplace, it'd be like Kuala Lumpur or some shit like that. Where was it, Remy?
I'm going to go in Munich and I don't want to talk about it.
Oh, okay. It was that bad. Yeah, okay. We'll just leave it at that.
there's a whole other Aberdeen story, but like Munich is definitely worse, and I'm not talking about it.
What happened?
I'll tell you later.
Yeah.
I'll text you now.
What Mike say is the worst flavor?
Like, he likes pretty much everything, so that's a tough one. He's not a fussy person. Maybe Marmite? Maybe?
Didn't even think about that, but that would work. I can't remember what I said. Oh, yeah, no, I know what I said.
What is it?
It was really obscure, but it happened. Yak butter tea is by far.
Ooh.
I mean, it's the same thing as Marmite, isn't it? I love Marmite. Marmite's amazing. But,
oh,
you know,
really?
Yeah. But if you're a Brit, like, you're 50-50, you know.
Yeah.
Wait, but yak butter? is not Marmite.
No, he's just saying it's gross.
I had goat fudge once, like fudge made from goat's milk.
I bet you did, buddy.
It's not that kind of podcast.
So I remember, like, that's my dad.
We went to a restaurant with friends, and our friend is like, she's a nutritionist, and she's like, oh, they make this homemade like goat fudge. You should try it. And me and my wife, like, okay. And they came out with this like goat fudge.
Just goat fudge, and then you move on. That's all you
taste of farm.
Yeah,
it was the most goat farm thing I've ever eaten.
I'm picturing it like a pate, but I guess
you guys are nodding like you've also had goat fudge.
You know, our son had I haven't had goat fudge, but I used to have to get our son goat's milk, and it just smelt like the goat farm that I got it from.
Yeah.
So I can't even goat. Wouldn't go.
Don't goats there. Don't goat. I gotta stop.
No, you don't. What's Remy's worst fear?
Being alone, no Michelle.
Mm. That's pretty. That wasn't there. But now you said that, I'm quite frightened. No, do you know what? No, actually, tsunamis.
Oh, yeah.
I spent 2 weeks in the Maldives, and every morning I would get up and I'd be like,
oh, yeah.
It wasn't even an earthquake and you were checking.
Yeah, I was just like, I was on point just in case. I mean, nothing, you know, if something happened, there was no high points. There was no buildings over one story. We were all dead. But, right. Yeah,
at least you could see it coming.
Yeah, I'm not really. I'm an only child. Like, things just washed over me. I'm not really scared of anything.
Except the thing that could wash over you.
Yeah, except, yeah. The irony.
Man, yeah, you got heaters. What will Mike say is the worst movie ever made?
Goonies.
I can't think of the worst.
I mean, to me, the worst film is The Lost Highway by David Lynch, because I think David Lynch was either so out of his face on drugs or had completely lost the plot. I was watching this film as a young adult thinking, what the fuck are you doing?
Yeah.
And I loved, you know, Blue Velvet and, you know, other stuff. And that was bad.
Yeah. This conversation comes up often. And everyone loves David Lynch, but that...
Yeah, but like Lynch fans, they get all like, no, you don't understand Lynch.
Yeah.
You don't understand Lynch, bruv. I'm like, listen, bruv, I understand Lynch. It's just shit.
Yeah, I guarantee nobody knows what the hell is going on with Lost Highway, including himself.
Yeah, I can't think of... Like, there's bad movies that I loved. You know, like, I mean, Attack of Killer Tomatoes is easy, but like Dark Star. You ever see that movie?
No.
Amazing film.
That movie's the best.
Big Trouble in Little China. Terrible. Maybe.
Right? Yeah, some of those bad movies are great movies, but
Caravan of Courage with the Ewoks. That was bad. That was bad. And they're going back there now. They're doing like Skeleton Crew, which is like Caravan of Courage 2024. It's like, stop that, now. Stop.
That's the name of the Ewoks movie where they live in the tree. That's
There was two. There was Caravan of Courage, and
one of them had the little speedy guy.
Yeah. Then what was the other one called? They were both terrible, but Caravan of Courage was especially funny. Bad.
Those are the Ewoks was the only one I could get into.
Yeah, Adrian's
of all the Star Wars.
I mean, you've seen a picture of my dog, so you know I literally live with an Ewok.
What does Remy think is the worst word?
The worst word.
No.
Oh, only child card again. Do you know what? It's my daughter spent her formative years watching a lot of Wizards of Waverly Place and a lot of Disney Channel. And one day she said to us, now in England we say celebratory. You say celebratory.
Yeah.
Yes.
It's like it literally is tomato, tomato. And I was like, so what did you say? She's like, well, it's celebratory. And I was like, celebratory.
Celebratory. Yeah.
And I'm like, I don't know what you're talking about. And so to me, celebratory is like, it's like nails down the chalkboard.
Yeah.
If I could do one thing it, with my legacy, I would love to teach everyone in the world to say celebratory. Because you celebrate and it's celebratory.
Yeah.
Okay.
You guys have a lot of words that are I know you guys started the language, but man,
I'm glad we got that. I'm glad we got that out of the way.
You're saying some weird words.
Yeah, we do. We do.
You know. And the weird word.
Yeah. I loved on, we did a track with Open Mike Eagle. I got to saying, "Here I am between two blokes named Michael." As one of my, that's my favorite lyric. In the whole of the Deacon Rap album.
Now we're carbon heavy, maybe it's time to cycle. And here I am between two blokes named Michael. We may have lost the battle, but we won the title.
You know what's so funny? I've listened to that album a trillion times. I've heard the lyric, and I'm so stupid. I just realized that it's Open Mike Eagle that you're talking about.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, here I am between two blokes named Michael. And he, you know what? He like when he heard the record, he replies, "I really like it. It's really cool." He's like, "I love your lyric about two Michaels."
Yeah, he's awesome, and that's an awesome track. Who will Mike say is the worst hair band from the '80s?
David Lee Roth, the legend. So it's not. Maybe Guns N' Roses.
Yeah, I was never really a fan of Guns N' Roses.
Guns N' Roses suck.
Yeah, but they're not a big hair band. That's not a big hair band at all. That's tough, man. Because I just ran the other way.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Like I can't even name like the you know the Sticks, like who, there were so many, and I literally ran the other way. But you know, I mean, that said, some of those songs are stuck in my head and I love them now. But
yeah.
But you got to go down the line because like. Even Warrant had at least one song you could chop up and turn into a sample.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, like Cherry Pie? Here's the last worst question, then we'll go to favorites questions. What will Remy say is the worst brand of spray paint?
Krylon. Oh.
It's so
112%. It's the
Yeah.
Worse is UK Krylon, which is even worse than American Krylon. Terrible paint.
Yeah, we don't even get it in the States anymore. Do they still make it?
I think they do make it, but I think it's a very different formula. Like, paint has changed so much. Like, the industry of spray paint has changed.
Yeah. We only get Valspar. This shit's Valspar, and it's garbage.
Yeah. There's so many bad. I was in...
All these boutique paints coming out, like, aren't there like special graffiti paint?
The thing is, the pigments are so bad in them, like you use it on a wall, 3 days later it's faded. Like I remember going to Miami Art Basel 1 year and all these people like using this Australian paint,
iron lac.
Iron lac was like supporting everything, and they're gonna hear this, the Iron Lac people, and they're gonna like, you know, send me like hate mail. But basically the next year I went back and I was like, took my friends to show them this like really nice wall by like Dabs and Myler and Tyke and la la la, and you know, I'm like, where are the walls? They literally just faded to nothing, like all white. Like in less than a year, it just gone. So that's pretty bad paint.
Yeah, we use that a lot.
I use German paint, Molotov, which is one of the better ones.
Yeah. Oh my God. And you're a big Star Wars fan. Before we sign off, I have to show you this. I have this drawing of a Rancor chewing on a Molotov can.
Amazing.
It's exploding, and in the background, I redid Banksy drawings. I did a same Basquiat's tag. Yeah, I'll show it to you. Yeah. What's Remy's favorite TV sitcom from the 80s or 90s?
The Wombles.
Sitcom? That's a cartoon.
That's to me. From the 80s?
Yeah, 80s
or 90s. You can guess. Come on.
Ever a British version of Three's Company? Because you got a little Jack Tripper in you, bro.
It's not. It's the Young Ones.
Oh my God, it's my favorite show of all time. Cornflakes, cornflakes, cornflakes.
Then you gotta say in 10 words what cornflakes mean to you. So I put cornflakes, 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 cornflakes. Pathetic.
You never win, Vivian.
Why not?
It's It's only 9 words.
Cornflakes.
Cornflakes.
Rick Mayo is God.
Yeah,
the young ones, man. I used to watch that. My mum was like, you probably shouldn't be watching this. And my dad was like,
back on my UK comedy, I just discovered the Mighty Boosh.
Oh, my kids love the Mighty Boosh.
Me and my daughter, the Boosh. That's next level.
Goddamn, yeah. Shit, I have so... There's so... Oh, man. I was Vivian in the fifth grade. I was Vivian for Halloween. Speaking of Halloween.
Amazing. Oh, the young ones was classic.
This is an original Noel Fielding piece.
Oh, wow.
From the Don't Walk Walk Gallery in
amazing. Stuff's really like surprisingly affordable.
Yeah.
Like I've got a book of all his work that my wife bought me. I love Noel Fielding, Mighty Boosh.
Yeah, he's just a funny dude. Yeah, I mostly buy stuff because of who you are. What's Mike's favorite thing about America?
Twinkies?
No, Twinks. Twinks, dude.
Twinks. I thought it was bears.
Everyone confuses the two.
Yeah, did they?
Yeah.
I guess it's something food related that you can't get in Paris. Something very
Yeah, Jamaican food, goddammit.
Yeah, like proper Jamaican food. At least you can get that in London, though.
Is there not like a proper Jamaican food in Paris?
No. There's one place called Jaja. You can get great Haitian food, great Martinican food, great Guadeloupean food.
But classic West Indian. No.
Oh, yeah.
I got to take the Eurostar.
He's got to come to see me for that. Or go Birmingham or London. It's the only place.
Who is Remy's favorite artist of all time?
Oh, shit. This one I know. Sort of post-structuralist dude, right?
Yep.
I'll
give you a clue.
Yeah, I know exactly who it is. Fanny.
Calling for help. Calling the.
Oh,
the,
man. He's phoning a friend. He's like, no,
phoning a friend.
I know I can't Google stuff, but at least I thought I could call my wife. We have the pillows. We went and saw the show.
Begins with M.
Malcolm. It's an Eastern European name. It's like, sounds like Malkovich, but it's not.
Malevich. Master.
Well, you and he's post structuralist, right?
Yeah, completely.
Did you go to? Are you school? Did you go to school for art?
No, I did a foundation, which is like a 1 year thing. I'm not formally trained. I don't think formal training would have helped me in any way.
Right, and you're British. You guys have people out over there have a better understanding of the art world and everything, because you could name a trillion artists and I wouldn't know any of them.
I mean, to be honest, I just went out and bought a shit ton of books and I read books. I still read books. Like I buy books all the time. And, you know, like I probably know more about art than a lot of the artists I know that went through art school and then did master's degrees, you know, and as far as the, yeah, history of art world concerned, I know a ton, you know, and that's just from buying books and reading stuff. And
well, that's the other thing that you got. You guys are smart. You read.
I mean, yeah, everyone reads, but you know.
I've tried so often and I just can't. I buy books. I got a shelf full of books and I'll read 3 pages and then I go, I want to be drawing. And I it's been my whole life.
But you're drawing, you're creating, and that's a beautiful thing. So
I get lucky. I do get lucky with that. I guess Mike probably taking a protein piss break.
I think he needed a plug.
No. I'll give you a plug. The Dead Can Rap album.
The Dead Can Pee.
What is Mike's favorite source of transportation?
Walking.
Is that correct?
No, that he's right, because that's what I do now, but actually I prefer biking, but I've been walking because it's better for my health than biking.
Oh, yeah.
I stopped using public transportation. So I just like, even if, like, for example, I'm rehearsing with this band every day, and they're about 8 kilometers, 2 hour walk every day.
Oh.
Walk there, and then I walk the 2 hour.
Walk back. You get a 4 hour, well, that's, or 4 mile, four, I don't know what kilometers are.
Yeah, it's about 5 miles.
Yeah.
So I'm going to teach everyone to say celebratory and go metric.
I know. We should be doing metric. It makes no sense. I don't understand it. But don't you guys, you guys now are using some of our measuring and...
Well, we still use miles.
Yeah, England's like mix and match.
Yeah.
You guys are like 1 foot in, 1 foot out. You know. I'm like, no, I'll just dabble.
Dabblers.
It's Remy's favorite holiday.
Christmas.
Is it? Oh,
Christmas,
that's everyone.
And Easter all wrapped into one.
Yeah.
The lads came actually a couple of years back, kind of just before Christmas, and they could see how serious we take Christmas.
Yeah, you guys do. What is Mike's favorite sound?
I'm going to say the sound of his family.
Mm, a sweet one.
He has a very beautiful family and two beautiful kids who I'd love dearly.
Yeah, that's awesome.
So I'm going to say that, but that's probably one of them.
That's throwing it now. How is he going to go against that? What?
Yeah, that's what I should have said.
I like the sound of a moo.
That Remy's so right. Good for you, Remy. You're amazing. How'd you come up with that one?
I'm looking for brownie points for fun. Yeah.
Is that what you're going to go with? Is that your answer?
Mine was so moist, but it's true. Like, you live in Paris and like, you can hear people nut. Because this is the way everyone lives so densely.
Yeah.
And in the summertime, you'll hear people having these crazy orgasms. And it's just nice. It's like, you know, there's not many birds here or anything, but every now and then you just hear someone like, woo, 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 woo.
There's no birds here.
My wife is like holding me back, but I really just want to put my head up and be like, yeah! It's me, man! It's really beautiful. It's a very Parisian thing, and because it's just a way... Everything's stone. All the buildings are really close together. And so in the summertime, the windows open.
Mike's favorite sound is someone nutting.
Oh, that's the favorite sound.
Quite different to what I said, but we'll move on.
Quite very different. Well, families always start with a nut.
Yes, yeah, exactly. Every family starts with a nut. Yeah.
What's Remy's favorite cartoon of all time?
The Wombles. Going with the Wombles again. Going with the Wombles for 300. That or Spider-Man.
Spider-Man.
Oh, is that the answer? Spider-Man
and his amazing friends.
I'm like 5 for 10 or 20 here.
I love that. I love coming home from school, sitting down on the sofa. My mom would turn the TV on. Spider-Man.
I never, ever. My daughter loves Spider-Man. What's wrong with you?
I also did not.
I am not a
Spider-Man fan.
Okay, I got another question. Do you hate Jim Morrison?
Me?
Yeah.
No, I'm a fan. I because one of the first thing I ever heard of him when I was younger, I got the tape, the American Prayer tape, and I just loved it. And so, okay. Yeah. But
I thought maybe there was like a line, because it's really hard to find people who hate Spider-Man. Or who just don't get Spider-Man. And so I thought maybe then you also didn't get Jim Morrison.
That makes sense.
Like, I got a theory about...
You hate Jim Morrison?
I have a really hard time with that, dude.
Yeah.
Yeah, like, well, likewise, I'm disappointed in him.
Well, as a person, he was a terrible person.
Yeah, I feel like his writing is super pretentious and stuff. But there's a couple of Doors songs that I really like. you know, like the end and shit like that.
But, yeah, I was never. I wasn't very much into the Doors at all. I just liked I liked that American Prayer where it's just him. He's just drunk in the studio reading his poetry, and it's not even that great of writing. But there's something about it that I kind of like. Maybe it was just so different than all the other Doors stuff. And yeah, I wasn't a big Doors fan. I'm also not a big huge. Well, no, that's not true because I love. Never mind. What is Mike's favorite city or town in the world?
Probably New York.
I said the Bronx.
Yeah. Yeah, that place is special. I mean, probably more special when you grow up there.
I mean, I only lived there for like 8 years, but I just really liked it. Mm-hmm. It was crazy. It was like 3 people got killed in my building. This is when me and Rob Sonic lived together. So that was part of it because it was like Rob was 2 stories above me. And then across was Fred Ones, who's a brilliant DJ and producer. DJ Preservation was living 2 stories above Fred Ones. And that was the crew. It was called TME. It was the spot. I mean, it was great.
You made a comment earlier about Paris sort of being crazy now or something, and that's what you kind of liked it. And I'm wondering, do people like who live in New York City kind of are attracted to that, to chaos?
Nah, well, I mean, it's 2 really different cities. You know, like every city's got a voice, right? You know, like New Orleans is like, fuck a fight, boy. You know, which one are you going to do? And then New York is like pretty much get up and get your ass in gear or you're going to be dead like this person you're walking over right now.
Mm-hmm.
And Paris's voice is like, let's go have a coffee. Yeah. It's time for lunch.
Yeah.
I think it's time for a Perot now. And oh, look, it's dinner time. I'm sleepy. Let's go to bed. Yeah. So it's like a way more relaxed type vibe. So, I mean, it's a crazy city by European standards and certainly by French standards. But it's not by New York standards. It's like living in. Also, you know, I mean,
yeah,
I think I've learned to appreciate it more through you, Mike.
But what I like is a bustle. What I like about it now is just it's become really mixed, you know, just much more mixed than it used to be. When I first moved here, it really was the center of town was pretty much reserved for tourists, and there's like this desperate attempt to sort of keep it going. I mean, it's a strange place, you know. It's the only city I think in history whose beauty saved its own life. You know what I mean? Like when the Allies were coming in, Hitler was like, "Raise that city to the ground," and Choselitz, who was in charge of Paris, was like, "I spent 4 great years here. When I get out of jail, I want to come back." You know, and since then, there's this sort of like this almost mortal narcissism that's set in. You know, which can be really stifling because everything London, nothing sacred, you know, like there's architectural disasters all over the place, but it gives you permission to sort of, if you live around mistakes, you can make mistakes as an artist. So it's an easier place to live. In Berlin, New York is exactly the same thing. All of America. I mean, I think part of the reason why it's still so vibrant artistically is because you're just living in a, you know, aesthetic disaster area all the time. So you're free to make any mistake you want to make and sort of experiment. And architecturally and environmentally, you kind of got to get outside of this beautiful, precious thing that Haussmann had designed for everyone. And Napoleon bankrupted the country building. But that is remarkably beautiful to look at, but can be stifling if you're a creator. You know,
yeah, I mean, what it an is, interesting I, take.
I do, you know, I do love walking around here, and I, you know, I do it all the time now, peeking in people's windows, waiting for them orgasm.
Walking kilometer after kilometer just for.
Oh, but
for a nut. A squirrel collecting nuts.
I'm out there. Oh, winter's coming.
What is Remy's favorite cereal?
Captain Crunch. You don't even have Captain Crunch, do you? Weetabix.
Weetabix.
I love Weetabix. I do love Weetabix. It's not my favorite.
trying to remember, because there's like specific English stuff. I remember we had English cousins when I was little, and the one thing that blew my mind was the pink panther chocolate bar. Do you remember that?
Oh. Yeah.
That thing blew my mind. It was like pink chocolate, which sounds like a Rick James song, but it was incredible. But I can't think of any British cereals though.
Weetabix is good. It's not my favorite. My favorite's crunchy nut cornflakes.
Oh.
Okay. Yeah, we got those.
But I don't have those. I never have them in the morning. That I will have if I've come home from being out at a thing. Me and my wife get home and it's like 10 o'clock at night and you think it's too late to like make food. Cereal.
Yeah, that's the best time. All right, here we go. The final favorites question. Then we'll let you guys get out of here. Who is Mike's favorite comedian?
That's a tough one. Because it will probably be an American one, and it will probably be one from the 80s.
You want a hint?
Yeah, go on.
Best hint I can give you is the 70s and 80s.
I was going to say Richard Pryor.
But that's one of them.
Yeah, I was going to say Richard Pryor or Eddie Murphy.
Richard Pryor is, you won with Richard Pryor because I put down two.
Yeah.
The other one was Pryor's, one of Pryor's mentors was Paul Mooney.
Yeah. Oh. Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
I'd forgotten him, but yeah, amazing.
Yeah, he is. I love that dude.
Do you know a comedian called Stuart Lee?
Yes.
British shit. Yeah. Like, he is.
Yeah.
He's my favorite.
You guys have so many. No, people over here in America don't get it.
I don't know. Like a lot of the Brits are touring the States at the minute. There's an amazing woman called Jen Brister. If you get a chance to see her in the States,
okay. I'm always looking.
Unfortunately for us, when they come here, they mostly go to New York. They mostly just go to the
Jen's,
East Coast.
Jen's doing a big tour around, okay. I'll tell you who else is doing a tour: Ramesh Ranganathan.
We saw him last night.
Awesome. Yeah, he was amazing. I love him.
We were just there. We were just in London in March.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Well, next time let's link up. Let's go for lunch next time you're here.
I will for sure. We went to dinner with Buddy Peace when we got there.
Ah.
We went out to his spot and had lunch with them. Yeah.
Did you go to Margate?
Yeah.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
I saw Nick was up the other week. We were hanging around together. He's amazing. Love Buddy Peace.
Yeah.
Very underrated talent.
Yep. I guess that's the what you call. I love him. I love him. I love his music. I love every part of him. There you go, folks. We've been served. Served the dish. I'm stuffed. Check, please. Hey, did you learn anything new about yourself or about your homie?
No.
Yes.
Oh, yes and no.
I literally, this has actually probably been one of the worst 2 hours of my life. And I'm trying really hard to forget about it.
Brand new. This is like fucking mental Pilates.
I mean, I kind of feel abused at this point, but you know.
Like I said, thank you again, Remy. Much better.
Well, we're genuinely grateful to you guys for joining us.
We're very grateful as well.
Yeah, it's been great. Thank you so much for serving us. We'll leave you a good tip, but we won't leave a tip. Well, you guys are they tipping in either one of your guys' place now?
Service charge.
Yeah, tipping's getting out of control in the States.
I don't know, there's a whole NPR thing on. Go on tipping.
It's out of control here.
We did cow tipping. You know, that's the thing. Brits, you know, like.
Whoop. You go up to Scotland and tip a few.
Yeah.
I found out when we were there, when we were eating, you know, we ate out the whole time. And I was like, I think we're actually saving a lot of money
by not
eating
tipping.
in England.
Yeah.
This is done, man.
Means I'm down to the shot.
There you go, folks. Thank you so much. Big yawn from Adrian. We're getting ready to get out of here. It's thanks so much, Remy
it's
and Mike.
Not because of them.
No, I know. Thanks so much, Remy and Mike, for spending time with us and sharing your answers to your first, worst, and thirst. It was just a really great time. I had a really great time having you on the show this week. That's what I like about doing this Friday night thing is I can say that this week was The Dead Can Rap Week. So I also want to thank Rob Sonic for being pals with those guys, because it was after his episode that Remi reached out to me. Oh. After Rob Sonic's episode, Remi watched it and reached out to me. So I'm glad that all happened, because I really did enjoy that conversation with Mike Ladd and Remi Rough.
Me too. And I just want to say that I think that we were in like high gear or something, and I didn't get the chance to listen to them. I will just say that I have had the opportunity to listen to the Dead Can Rap, and I would pick them every day of the week over the band that they love. Which is, what's the band's name?
Oh, now that you just said it,
YouTube,
totally lost
me. Coldplay.
No, neither of those.
Man. Radiohead.
Radiohead.
Yeah, I'll take Dead Can Rap every single day of the week over...
Well, I'm sure they're honored, and I'm sure there's a lot of Radiohead fans out there whose heads are just fucking blowing up.
Well, it's okay. They can have Radiohead, and I can have Dead Can Rap.
But I will say, I am a huge fan of Dead Can Rap. I'm just a really big fan of both their music, separately and together. Together, they're like Voltron, outside their own great entities.
I have not listened to them individually yet.
Well, there's a whole playlist, the DOD45... Dead Can Rap, DOD45. That's a whole playlist of all their music.
Both of
that's
them.
It's streamable. Yep. All in one spot.
Anyway, just had to say that.
Great. I appreciate you saying it. I really enjoyed having them on. They're also just really cool guys. I love a British accent. Mm-hmm. Everyone on that watches our show regularly knows that my favorite thing is British television, British, just the UK in general. Yeah, they seem like they've got good things going for them. I hope we can meet them in person.
They've got a good relationship with each other, too. They're funny.
Yeah. Funny. Like a married couple.
They're funny like our cat and any one of us. Like,
funny relationship.
We're all like, let's snuggle. And the cat's like,
no, thank
you're
you.
Fine at the foot of the... You're like, you're fine. I'm like, go away.
Well, last time we were out in the UK, we got to go visit Buddy Peace. In person. I hope when we got there again, we get a chance to meet up with Remi, maybe even Remi and Buddy.
Yeah.
And then when we get to France, I'd love to shake hands with Mike Ladd.
What if he's not a handshaker?
Well, I'll bump fists. I'll give a hug. I'll even do the cast one trick. Hey, does my collar smell like vanilla? Oh, we haven't talked much about it, but the recording with... for our Old Blue Live show, that was a lot of fun. I think it was a huge success, and it's just going to grow. So I don't know. We don't know when that's going to be out yet, but we did the recording work. I've got to mix it and edit it and stuff, but hopefully that'll be out this winter.
And I do have some information on it. If you want to be invited to one of the recordings, the upcoming future recordings, if you go on Instagram to Old Blue Gallery Live, and that's OL Blue Gallery Live, then you can just like subscribe to that or whatever, follow it. And updates will
you'll get updates come
through. And if you know if we have a show coming up, you can hear about it, and I'll give you more information then.
Yeah Right. Cool.
I am not doing well.
Nope. Yeah, it's late, and it's a strange day today. I won't mention what the day is today, but we don't know certain things yet, and it's a strange, just a bizarre day and a busy day. So, all right, let's play a video real quick. Let's get a laugh in, and then let's get out of here.
You see what this is? This is a bottle of cinnamon. Cinnamon is some sort of a powder that you put into cakes, and it makes them taste nice. That's fine. This is a tablespoonful of cinnamon. Now, somebody's tried to tell me that putting a full spoonful, and this is not a full spoonful, it's a tablespoonful of cinnamon in your mouth at once is impossible. And I've seen all these younger people than me who's shoving this stuff in their mouth and then they're all over the place because they can't take it. Well, believe me, I've faced worse than tablespoonfuls of cinnamon during my life. People have thrown things at me all my life, and all my life I've head-butted them away or taken the challenge. I'm going to take the challenge now. This is one of the fullest tablespoonfuls of cinnamon I've seen in the various challenges that I've seen recorded.
He's
mine's
so
going to
confident.
Be the best of all. And I bet you I won't even balk, okay? I won't even balk because I've been trained to take pain, okay? I've taken pain all my life. Here we go. I'm told there should be an explosive reaction. There won't be from me. I'm going to count you down. 3, 2, 1.
Ha!
people doing this?
Water!
Oh, look how red he is.
What
is... Gosh. Okay, well, let me show you this one then.
Oh man, that he was so cocky. I've never done it. I don't think I'll ever try it. I mean, I've heard that it's. I believe shit when people.
Okay, well, this is good enough. No, this is good enough.
Okay, I'm so excited to show you my new favorite thing, milk tea. I had it for the first time today. Okay, wait, hold on. I had it already for the first time today, and it was so good. I went back, and I was like, please, can I have some more? Oh, hold on. It's hot. Oh, it's hot in here. I'm from Texas, y'all. Oh, goddammit. I'm out of fuel. Anyways, milk tea is so good. She said I had to try the babas in it this time, so I had the little... She said to shake it, and I think they're supposed to dissolve. But I'm obsessed. You just poke a hole in it. Oh my god, I choked on something. My car. Oh my god. Fuck off. What the fuck did I choke?
That's all. It was just ridiculous. That's all. It was just so, like, I was like, what? This isn't even funny. And then, like, 10 minutes later, I just kept thinking about him, like,
I think
not knowing that, like,
the boba tea has
that were going to go down your throat.
Yeah, I saw the video because I had my very first time. I had a boba tea while we were in Louisville. At that show, yeah. They showed
the
video.
The kids. Oh, yeah. I thought you were not paying attention. To
no,
that.
Yeah, oh, it was funny. For me, and I don't know if this is going to come off well, but just
those type of people,
I was like fucking so happy.
The influencer culture where you have to video yourself doing everything.
Yeah, and listen, I probably will cut this out, but that gets on my nerves. But yeah, that's funny.
Anyway, that was in Louisville. I thought it was
fun video.
Ridiculous.
All right, everybody. Thanks again to the Dead Can Rap.
Yes,
thank you guys for joining us, Mike Ladd and Remi. Yes, thank you. Buy their music at the Dead Can Rap, thedeadcanrap.bandcamp.com. Also, go dive into all of Remi Ruff's music and all of Mike Ladd's music. Anything they're involved in, just consume it. It's all really good stuff. Keep your melons on a swivel and your ears open for when either one of them are dropping new music. Also, if you're wealthy enough, consider commissioning Remi Rough for his artwork, because that dude is mad talented.
Well, not even if you don't even have to be very wealthy. I don't think he sells his work on his website.
He does. I was thinking more along the lines of like if you have a whole mural, because painting a whole other.
But you can still support his art.
That's true. You can buy his pieces. Yeah, because he does the little smaller wall paintings. Yeah.
No, he does like watercolor things.
That's what I mean. Sorry. Paintings that you hang on your wall.
Oh, yes.
Yeah. So check out his work at Remi Rough on Instagram. They're both mad talented individuals. So, please support them. I'm so grateful to them for being on our show. Next week we're chilling with Mopes to discuss his new album, Daddlebrook. That is a terrific discussion. Mopes is always a great person to spend time with. And I feel like we have a good relationship with him. I think that's probably... due to him, he's just a really downer, but just a really good dude.
You know, every time I hear his name, Mopes, and I don't know why.
I hear something.
What do you hear?
I hear Sage going, Mopes!
I hear, and it's not going to come out of my voice right, I'm probably doing it wrong, but I hear Mope-a-dope. I don't know what that is.
That's the Beastie Boys. Mope-a-dope! The newest in new.
Yes.
Right up to your face and diss you. Waxing and milking.
Yeah.
All of your sweats. Yeah.
But then I didn't want to say that.
Why?
That sounds rude.
No, it doesn't.
Mope-a-dope.
Mope-a-dope.
I don't even know. What is rope-a-dope?
That's rope-a-dope. Weird. That's a boxing term when you're giving them the rope-a-dope.
I'm like, oh, no. I hope it's not like something to do with like lynching people.
No.
And then a dope. If you're roping a dope.
As you'll learn in our discussion with Mopes next week, he doesn't give a shit about any of that. About terms being called anything, any of that. No, you'll see. It's a really cool discussion.
Of course he does.
No. I know. You'll get what I'm
He's
talking
just
about
a sweet
when you listen to the episode. He's like, oh, I have no time to worry about shit.
Why do I want to call him a kid?
Well, I mean, I think you and him are the same age.
Okay.
Yeah. Actually, I think you're a year older than he is.
But he is. He's a sweet kid. Yeah. I can say that.
Because he's a year younger. No, he is a really good dude. Love him. Love him lots. So yeah, be sure to check out that episode next week, Mopes. And if in the meantime, go put your ears all over that Dettobrook album. I've said it before and I'll say it again and over. It is a perfect album. And I know that sounds like it sounds it doesn't sound real, but I really mean it. It's so good.
It is good.
It just hits right. It just hits right.
I respect their decision to only release that on Bandcamp, but
I want it on vinyl.
I was trying to make a playlist on Halloween, and I couldn't add it. So it
I agree. I respect it. I do hope that they release it so I can get access to it where I could play it in a playlist.
Yeah.
Hey, following that week, don't miss our 100th episode with our mystery guest. Fuck. All right, we got to get out of here. Thanks for watching our show. Thanks for supporting my art. That's us done. Adrian, any final words? Oh, boy.
Peace.
God, I can't believe this. All right, from all of us here, I'd like to wish you happy drawing, happy conversing. Thanks for spending your evening with us. Please tell your friends and family about the DOD45 show and have yourself a terrific weekend. We Black are going to miss you.
Black Book is not
nope,
here
this
today.
Is a dish.
Okay, bye.
All right, goodbye.
DOD45.
Thank you for joining in on yet another episode of the DOD45 show. Please hit the subscribe or follow button so that you never miss an episode. You can even go one step further by leaving us a review on the YouTube stream or on Spotify, Apple Podcast, or wherever it is that you stream our show from. You can find me at ArtByTai on all the socials or at ArtByTai.com. And if you'd like to follow the DOD45 show on social media, we're at DOD45W on Instagram, or you can go over to our website at DOD45.com where you can shoot us an email, join our mailing list, and watch all of our past episodes. Consider joining us for a live chat on the YouTube premieres of episodes every Wednesday night at 8 p.m. Eastern. Peace.